Rob Terell, the official Dealmaker. After representing 5 multi-platinum, 2 gold, and a Grammy winner, I've seen a lot, learned a lot, and grown a lot in this business. After 27 years in the game, as an exec, I figured out I'm not in the music business. I'm in the business of music. Atlanta is my city, and artists know when they come to me, they will become industry.
Cass, what's up, man? What's good, my guy?
Rob Terell, how you doing, my nigga?
Blessed, bro. Blessed. I would be doing a lot better, man, if you and T-Lo stopped playing games with my artists, bro. What are you guys talking about, bro? We need 5 backstage passes on that Trippie Red concert. We need a merch table. Hold up, Cass, just hear me out. We need a merch table so that my artist can sell his merch so he can make his money back, bro. And I don't know where T talking about $5,000. When you and I spoke, man, I told you, man, like, can you do it for 3 or 35, bro? I really want it for 3. 35 would be the max, Cass. Like, I don't know what's going on here. I'm not with the Jedi mind tricks, my G. Like, this is business. Bro, listen, bro. How much money has my company and my peoples ran through UT and the whole squad? This ain't our first rodeo, bro. How many shows did we do with y'all last year? Bro, we done spent, bro, listen, Cass, we done spent over 6 figures with you guys. You know what I'm saying? It's like, at what point do y'all give a little? You know what I'm saying? At what point do y'all act like I'm a 7-figure that gave you 6 figures, that's putting food on your table, I'm sending kids to college, my guy? Like, what are you talking about, bro? I need $3,500 on the slot, and I need a merch table and 5 backstage passes. What?
It's something with you, Wealth Nation, man. You're talking about $1,500? You're really asking me for a lot here.
To go from 5 to 35? I really want 3, Cash. What?
I don't need an independent artist on this tour for $5,000.
Bro, I know it's Trippie Red. I know it's ASU. I don't know all that. I know y'all be on this fly Lil Wayne, Kodak Black, and all that, bro. I get it, man. But, you know, this is Sony, baby. This is Universal in the building. You know what I'm saying? Like, this ain't Donald Duck and Scooby-Doo, my guy. Like, we official over here. This is Wealth Nation. This is Rockstar. You feel me? Like, listen, bro. What can you do, man? Like, what's the best you can do?
You want a 6-foot table with a skirt so he can sell his merch.
Yes.
I can maybe do 3 backstage passes. I don't know about 5.
What can you do on the price for the slot?
I gotta talk to my peoples, man. And my hands are tied. I don't make those kind of decisions by myself. I gotta talk to my peoples.
Cass, look. All right, look, Cass. Check this out, man. You got an artist, right? You got that girl. You got that girl coming up out of New York. What's her name? Shy something. Your artist, Shy?
Shy Marie.
Yeah, Shy Marie. Look, bro. What about if I give you major label distribution deal for her and I've used a Sony machine behind her? Her streams are horrible. Her YouTube views are down. She don't have enough subscribers. I looked at her Apple Music. Bro, you need help. Y'all ain't really on them digital analytics like that, man. You know you need a machine behind her. So if I give you the machine and the team, I need $3,000 on a slot fee. I need 5 guest passes backstage, and I need the table. What we gonna do when they come for you? What we gonna do, bro? What we gonna do, man? Like, listen, bro. I just offered you $5,000 worth of, bro. Like, y'all got the concerts and all that, but y'all don't have the Sony machine. I have that. I have access to the big machine. Y'all could do the big concerts, but bro, I got the big machine. I got the whole thing. Y'all got a piece of a puzzle. I got the whole puzzle. $3,000 on a slot fee, 5 guest passes, merch table, no cap, no BS. What we gonna do, man?
He say, girl, you look good with the racks. She's stacking up in all white, looking all godish. I say, oh, you look good too, babe. What's up? Let's take a ride together. Go get this money.
Home, you know? And I really rock with your vibe. So how was the trip?
It wasn't too bad.
It wasn't too bad?
It wasn't too bad. Like 7 hours.
Like 7 hours? Yeah. You tired?
A little bit.
I'm
good, though.
You good? Mm-hmm. No doubt. So look, I'm going to get down to business. So exactly what we expected. Is where your brand is at right now. It's like you have the look, you have the talent. I love the music. The musicality is there. Now we have to prove the brand. So the brand has to be proven, like I said to you on the phone, beyond a reasonable doubt. Actually need to get to undeniable. Right now, you're not investable, not because of your music, but because of your brand. This artist development package that we talked about, that you put the deposit on, it's going to be full rounded. It's going to give you all the missing pieces so that you can get to monetization.
Okay.
You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
So you put a $2,000 deposit on the package, right? So there's $3,000 balance. So you want to pay that through Cash App, Zelle, Venmo. You have cash on you, how are you paying that?
So, coming here, a lot of stuff happened. Like, you know, I went through a lot coming here. I already told you on the phone, like, everything I've been going through. So, I mean, it's hard to come up with all that money at one time.
What do you mean you went through a lot of stuff? What are you talking about?
I mean, I had to give this person that, and I mean, the money just, I don't have it.
What does that have to do with me?
I mean, nothing, but I mean, I don't have it.
What do you mean you don't have it? Whoa, wait a minute. What do you mean you don't have my money? You just drove all the way up here from Florida and you don't have my bread? What type of games you playing, Pimpress? Did you know about this?
No, I didn't know about this at all. Like, why didn't you call me? You should have let me know. We've been communicating. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, you drove up here. You drove 7 hours. You didn't think to like bring that.
Wait a minute. You came all the way up here to Atlanta to meet with us, and you don't have the bread?
I'm not playing any games. I just don't. I don't have that money anymore. Like, I don't have it.
So why did you come if you don't have the money? Did you notice when you was in Florida? Did you have the money when you left?
I had it before I left, and then I didn't have it. So then.
Then why did you?
I mean, I don't have all the money right now, at this moment.
But right now is when you need to have it, at this moment. Because that's what we talked about, that's what we agreed to, that's why I'm here. I'm not here to just have a conversation. I get paid to have professional consultations. This is what I'm talking about with these independent artists. This is straight BS, bro. You talking about, we was on the phone, you talking about everybody finessing out here, scamming, you know, people trying to hustle you out of your bread and all that. You, what are you doing right now? You trying to hustle me. I'm not even hustling you. You trying to finesse me right now? Like, what are you doing? You tell me, you trying to finesse me?
I'm not.
You want $5,000 package for two bands? Do you have any of the $3,000? The balance?
Nah, not on me.
Why are you here? Yo, bro, this is crazy. Yo, I told you my schedule today. You know what I got going on? I got filming for Netflix. I got meeting with Sony. I got all kind of shit going on, bro. Big money on the table. You got me up here on some bullshit. This is clown shit.
Saying goodbyes?
Saying hello.
You think your wife can hear you?
No.
Then why bother?
Maybe I'm wrong.
You're going to die.
Maybe not.
Goodbye to you, my trusted friend.
A new day is dawning. New ideas, new rules, new management.
We've known each other since we were 9 or 10.
Who is this?
The Marquis de Grammont.
Challenge him to single combat. Win or lose, it's a way out.
I don't sit at the table.
Your family does.
Please pray for me. I was the black sheep of the family.
Man has to look his best when it's time to get married. Or buried.
I'm going to need a gun.
Goodbye, my friend. It's hard to die.
If you win, the table will honor its word. You'll have your freedom.
Under the old laws, only one can survive. Failure to meet at sunrise will result in execution.
Last words, Winston?
Just have fun out there.
I want you to find your peace. But a good death only comes after a good life.
You and I left a good life behind a long time ago, my friend.
Let's start today.
You left Florida knowing you didn't have my bread and you ain't say nothing to nobody? Yo,
bro.
You got me up here crazy, bro. I'm losing money sitting here talking to her. It's kind of shit, bro.
You want to be an artist or something like that? What's going on?
Yeah, bro, you know, just a few things I've been thinking about, you know, since our last conversation, you know.
Mm-hmm.
First off, I want to thank you for the opportunity. You know, the A&R thing has been amazing.
Uh-huh.
Nothing less than, you know, but like I told you on the phone, bro, I'm an artist.
Yeah.
You know, I always find myself getting back to making and creating music and doing things to kind of try to, you know, further my career and my situation. I really just want to see if maybe we can set up a situation where, you know, you can
a situation?
Let's set up a situation for an artist.
Situation
for you?
With rock stars?
You ain't no artist.
As an artist.
You ain't no artist.
I'm an artist.
Where? You are A&R. You pounded it. Bro, you need to focus A&R, you need to drop this.
Do you want to be an A&R or do you want to be an artist? Like, what do you want to be when you grow up?
An artist, executive. I can be whatever I want to be. With the right help, with the right push, with the right team, that's what you preach. And it's, I want to be a part of that in any way possible.
Bro, you came to us as an executive. You camouflaged, bro. You flies, like, I mean, I respect what you're saying. I feel you, like, you know, whatever's in your heart is in your heart, bro. I respect that. But I'm just saying, you did come to us as an executive. I didn't even know you was an artist.
He ain't no artist.
Until a couple days ago.
Bro, who is you talking to?
Bro, you. Bro, you ain't no art. You ain't no A&R for that matter. Bro, you barely got artists.
Watch your mouth, bro.
Bro, I don't have to watch my mouth, bro. Ain't no mirror in front of me.